Good afternoon. I wish you all a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. Now, you will notice, of course, that in the video, the Queen of England wasn't exactly smiling. It was during the national anthem. The reason, of course, that she wasn't smiling was because, as she and all the royal family know, she is not the true heir to the throne of England. I am. Yes, that is correct. Me. Now, the problem is that I had to be banished to a small suburb in Westminster. I now live in a small housing estate in SW1. I also had to have electrocution lessons, which we will come to later. But in the meantime, of course, you can see the resemblance between me and the impostor who is now living at Buckingham Palace. Yes, there are many impostors. There's also a family in Australia claiming to be of royal descent. Of course, this is complete nonsense. The real royal descendant, as I mentioned earlier, is me. Now, you will of course notice that my clothing has slightly altered. My fashion has changed a little bit. Yes, I bought this in the charity shop down in Pimlico. Unfortunately, that's where I'm relegated to buying my stuff now, but it is silk. Now, I did mention electrocution lessons earlier, and because I was banished here by the royal family, they didn't want me to sound too much like Elizabeth Windsor, so they asked me to lower my voice, and now, of course, I sound a little bit more like David Attenborough. So I have decided that my voice should be around this level. Then it doesn't cause offence to the person pretending to be the real Queen of England. But for now, as I'm in private in my own flat, albeit not very salubrious surroundings, unfortunately, I can just be myself. Now, as I mentioned, I did used to live in a small cottage before I came to the flat here. Yes, you can see it wasn't a very large estate, but unfortunately, I had to give it back when they pushed me out. It's a sad state of affairs. Now, this time of year, we think of poor people, people who don't have much to eat. Now, I had the same problem in that I had to buy my Christmas shopping earlier in July, thinking about the lack of money and food that I might have at this cold and dark time of year. So I went along to Marks and Spencer's and pushed my trolley around on a Friday evening when they do most of the reductions with the yellow label on. You probably know the ones. So as I was turning the corner, there was a crowd of Filipino ladies arguing and shouting over a section of sandwiches that were all reduced. I pushed my trolley through and elbowed my way to the freezer section. There were three large turkeys, all reduced to £5. I bought all three. I ate them during the summer, but I saved one for Christmas, of course.
Well, I crawled out of bed about 3:45, grabbed my turkey gun and stumbled out the door. I never get up before the crack of dawn, but I'll be sitting at the roost before them first turkeys yawn. Yes, I will. If you want to get a turkey, need a lot more than luck. You can't just sit there like a dump cluck. It ain't like hunting bucks or waiting for a goose. You gotta sound sexy and learn to seduce. Turkeys kinda do it like this. So I grab my bag of tricks, scratch my head. Time to get them turkeys moving, wake them up from the dead. I reach for Old Faithful, my favorite call. Who'd around me up, I heard of them butterballs. I can taste them now. Now you gotta hold still. There still can be, there could be eyeballs in the bushes looking at me. Couldn't itch my nose. My butt began to hurt, and mosquitoes landing on the back of my shirt.
Yes, that's how they get caught. Now, my corgis, of course, wanted to take part in the celebrations, but unfortunately, I received some rather bad news. Now, I was going to explain everything for the BBC, but they refused to show my clip because of the expletives I used. So the BBC just made a little sketch about what really happened.
One is currently on holiday at Balmoral, and one has made a shocking discovery. One was feeling rather peckish whilst one was feeding one's beloved corgis, so one decided to have a little taste. Well, one was horrified to discover one's doggy meal was frozen on the inside. One's chef is supposed to prepare fresh food for one's corgis, and one is not amused. One promptly shoved the chef's nose in the dog food to make one's point. One does not take lightly the abuse of one's best friends, and unfortunately, one now has a rather runny bottom.
Isn't that disgraceful? My corgis were simply not amused. My royal subjects, I just want to end by saying that Philip got rather bladdered the other day. I mean, he had a bladder infection, so he's been away for the while, which of course leaves me here to eat all the turkey, mince pies, lashings of cream, sherry, pure malt in oak casks, a cranberry sauce, Christmas crackers, exchange all the presents and open them all myself. But that's a rather unfortunate existence for me. It goes with the privilege of the job. So I'm going to pass you on to our first clip now, which is my brother at Westminster Cathedral. I hope I've got that in the right order.
Yeah. So there's a travel lodge in... She sent me a link. It's about 5 miles outside, 5 miles away from where she's getting married.
Oh, yeah.
And I think it's £17 a night or £20 a night. Because she did say I could stay at hers the night before, but, you know, it'd be too much. Yeah, so it is on. So I've just been...
March, did you say?
Yeah, March, the day she's getting married. There's a lot going on in March, because I've got a gig on the 9th.
Oh, yeah.
In Hatfields, and I'm me and Mary's birthday. Jesus, going senile here, and what else? The birthday, the wedding.
Yeah.
So St. Paddy's Day, obviously. Yeah. So I'll probably have another gig around
there. Course, yeah, last year.
Yeah, that's it.
Yeah.
So yeah, a few things on. So the camera's rolling anyway. So
is it?
It's over to you for your news.
Okay. Well. Hello, a happy Christmas here in Westminster Cathedral Cafe with Kevin, just discussing what we're doing for Christmas. I'm off to Italy, parli italiano and poi, buongiorno, come stai? Yes, with the lady friend, so I'll be there for just 5 days and everything's going well. I'm actually working at South Westminster Clinic today. So, going very well, a bit tired, been busy. But I hope you're all well in Down Under. We'll be there next year to visit you. And have a lovely Christmas. Christmas! Happy Christmas! Bye! Okay, bye!
Bye!
Okay, Sunny.
Hello. Yeah, my name's Pete. Hello, everyone. Yeah, happy Christmas to you all, mate. I'm related to David Beckham, you see. I know you might not believe it, but I am, promise. I could have been a great footballer. Yeah, yeah, that's it. My thing is, I could have been a great footballer, yeah. Anyway, I thought I'd sit in the royal chair before the other one comes back from making a cup of tea and just wish you all a Merry Christmas, yeah. And Happy New Year and all that sort of thing. I've got a bit of turkey in the oven. It's a £5 one that I found in Marks and Spencer's about 5 months ago in July. So I thought I'd eat it in there and just enjoy myself a little bit. Do you know what I mean? Anyway, I've got to get off, you see, and play another game of football. You know, I'm in demand round here. So I'll be chatting to you all later. Hope you enjoyed the scene with Mo at Westminster Cathedral. The next one coming up is the Northern lot, the Thomases. Okay then, catch you all later. See ya.
This major raging panic attack.
So Jerry is opening my Christmas cake. Liz is salivating over it.
But yes, truly.
Tell the relatives here, Liz, what happened last year when you ate half of it.
I had a major wager panic attack, but then again, I did eat half of it, Kev, didn't I?
Yes, you did.
Oh my God, you made that.
Yeah, she's very talented.
Why don't you sell them?
I have. But you don't get your money back.
No, I don't suppose you do, actually.
For all the work.
Oh, isn't it beautiful?
Beautiful.
Oh, she's very talented. Isn't that lovely?
That's you, Kev.
Oh, isn't that lovely?
Find your accordion.
Oh, the accordion.
Yeah, look.
Oh, isn't that sweet?
Oh, I think that brings tears to my little eyes.
Oh, isn't that beautiful?
So, you'll have to play We're Walking in the
I might have a relapse though, Kev. Like a planned relapse.
Right. Yes, I think you might have it. Well, we're gonna have our chocolates at Christmas, aren't we?
Yeah, we're gonna have a planned
relapse. But Kev, because Kev and I are quite similar. You probably go. Kev and I just go. Half for you.
There's no half measures
half,
here.
No.
Well, there are half measures.
You know
measures.
Me and chocolates. I'm the
there
same.
There are half measures. Half for you and half for me.
Yeah, well,
that's half measures.
Yeah. Well, that's the way it should
and
be.
That's half a measure. And that
yeah.
Perfect.
So where are you off to on your date?
Oh, just meeting this one at Slams. The last one last week, it was my third date to the Silver Rolling Stones. £500 ticket.
Fantastic.
Each.
Fantastic.
And I haven't even kissed
him. Good.
That's the kind of date you want, isn't it? Yeah.
By the way, when I see the date this afternoon, my hair will be dry.
Yeah, she'll look absolutely gorgeous.
She will. She dresses up very nicely,
yeah,
does Liz.
I scrub up well.
She scrubs up well.
I scrub up.
We didn't say that, did we?
No, we didn't.
And so this one this afternoon, Jason.
Oh, Jason.
Nearly 60.
Oh, no, is
he? It's a bit old.
Yeah,
but
he's so old for you. Yeah, but you know what?
Oh, young.
He's a young 60 though, he's into boxing,
Listen, I've got them my Euro Millions there to check. You know,
oh, if you 40, want, Kev.
44 million.
Right, 4, 6, 10, 20, 30, 31,
48 million. 64
million.
Was it 64?
Yeah, Stevenage.
But do you know what, I hope that ticket goes to, I hope that money goes to good resources.
They're saying.
There's no
exception.
There's just console tax. The only thing that there is, I'm not going to.
We're here in this luxurious flat in Edenbury.
No expense spared.
Absolutely gorgeous. Having a beautiful fresh coffee and cakes.
You didn't read the script properly. So here we are.
In the heart of SW1.
So we've driven up here from Cheshire.
Yes.
Down. Not in one hit, because there's something wrong with the car.
So this is for everyone in Australia.
Hello!
We're coming out to see
Happy
you.
Happy Christmas!
We're coming out to see
you. Yeah, save me a bed for next Christmas.
Have you heard that somewhere before, yeah. Everyone in Australia? We're coming out to see
is
you.
The race to Australia. Well, John didn't have the money, but he thinks he can find it now.
Does he?
Yeah, from some insurance claim.
Oh, yeah.
Which hasn't yet been
settled. He thought it was going to be his pension, but I think that's gone by the by because they're ripping everyone's pension apart. But yeah, next Christmas, me and my friends are thinking about coming genuinely to Australia.
Right.
Via China.
Right.
Currently, flights are on the sale for £800.
Is this China Airlines?
No, we're rowing.
It'll be rowing.
But yeah, so keep an eye out.
Right.
We won't be able to afford to eat because I'll have spent it all on the plane.
Right.
Well,
yeah.
Mel can't keep you. She's not a minute.
It's all right. I've got friends in Sydney. So
have you?
Go stay with them.
Right. Good.
Yeah. Oh, we love the calendar, Mel. It was gorgeous. All the photos of Mum and you and the girls and John. Yeah. She really loved it. She showed it to Mark and I yesterday when we were there. And she was telling us bits about it where she'd visited and she loves it.
What
was
it,
nice.
Pictures as kids?
Yeah, when Mum was out there. Very good. The girls look very grown up.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Kaylee's very tall.
How old is she?
12.
What?
And
I know.
Laura
shocking,
12
isn't it?
Yeah. Is a little peach.
She's nearly a teenager.
Yeah.
Oh
my god. Yeah, she wants
to. Sarah, give us a quick rundown of India.
Hope you get your phone
for the rallies.
It was filthy.
England are doing well in the test.
It was crazy.
Yes.
And
your son. The strangest part was me and my friends were a tourist attraction for Indians.
Right.
I'm probably going to be on all the Indian villagers' mantelpiece now. I've got pictures with them and their families.
Right.
Tell Kev about the watch.
Two little girls came up to me in the street. Two little girls. They were about 15. And they were like, hello, what is your name? I said, Sarah, what's yours? And then they asked me how much my watch was.
Right.
And where they could get one from.
Blimey.
So I didn't tell them it was probably more expensive than their parents' wages.
You're giving me answers.
But yeah, it was really good. We went to Agra, Delhi, Jaipur and Udaipur.
Right.
Got some trains, which were quite nice, actually. Nice of the Northern Rail. And we went round all the fancy hotels that we couldn't afford to stay in and had high tea.
Ask Fad about it. I've replied to it.
Saw a multitude of temples and tombs and mosques and God knows what else.
Yeah,
Taj Mahal went there. That was amazing.
Right, wow.
Ate far too much curry.
I've put a stop on the letter.
And everything to be
the same. That's not happening.
Really?
What else we do? But yeah, it was really good. Really good time.
Nice. Glad to be back in Blighty.
Oh, delighted.
Isn't it lovely? You missed all the rain, actually, while you were away. It absolutely threw it down while you were away. I mean, the floods. It's got to be the wettest year ever, hasn't it?
Yeah, I heard about the floods, yeah.
And the least sun. We've had more sunshine in end of November, December than we've had all year.
Yeah. Yeah, it's hideous, isn't it?
Well, Buckingham Palace, they wouldn't let me in. I don't know why. I mean, I thought I looked pretty normal to me. Would you not say I was normal? Well, anyway, I just knocked on the door on this one here. He's in the toilet at the moment. And guess what I found in the larder? That's right. Would you look at that now, boys and girls and ladies and gentlemen? A lovely, lovely homemade cake. I don't know who made it, but anyway, found it out there. So I thought I'd slip it under my coat there and just borrow it for, there's a few hungry, poor parishioners here and I thought they could do with a bit of a mouthful, you know. So with a glass of sherry or something like that. Anyway, I've just come from St. Mass this morning and I'd like to just pray for you all there now, all you sinners. That's right, we think of these things at this time of the year, the poor and the sinners and all those terrible things that people do. Well, I'm praying for all of you and here's hoping that all those nasty things will be removed. Anyway, I'd like to say that at the end of this video there's going to be a few carols, so if you've got your carol sheets out you can sing along. We'll see you all next year for a prosperous 2013. God bless you all. Oh, I've just got to get out of the room with the cake. I hope it doesn't come back. Let's see if I can get out.
Okay, so here we are. Down at the Blue Cat.
The
Blue
Cafe.
Hello. Choosing. Oh, Anne's got a nice bracelet. I wonder who made that.
Wonder.
That looks like Moroccan lamps.
One of our friends, her daughter, works. She gets staff discount 50% off.
Yeah, if she was in here, we'd grab one off her. Yeah. Vicky.
And Jerry and I came down the other morning. They had to be used up by November.
Hello, Anne. Hello, Anne.
Bring cash to the island to help their Cuban relatives survive. This informal trade is worth billions of pounds every year. I actually find this quite ironic because Cuba's always made great play of the fact that it's independent. But in reality, it's always been, it's been very dependent. Dependent on the Soviet Union during Soviet times, and now it depends in large part on the United States and Cuban Americans for many supplies and for remittances. And that surely proves how fundamentally weak Cuba's economy actually is.
Hello. How are you doing? I found that out in the kitchen, you know. Aye. It was on the side out there. And I thought, well, I might just slip it under my coat here, borrow it for a couple of days, you know. Aye, just feed a few friends of mine in the neighbourhood, wee bit hungry, you know. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed that wee video of Anne and John, who were visiting from the south of Spain, overseeing the rallies up in Manchester. Anyway, The Queen may be coming on just to give a wee final message, but before she does, I just would like to say that, well, when I was a wee bit younger, I did a wee apprenticeship with a few tools, you know, but no the kind of tools for building houses, no, it was a wee apprenticeship, just making a few wee facial alterations of a few people. So I spent a wee bit of time courtesy of Her Majesty. Not the Majesty you saw earlier, but this one.
Barlinnie Prison wakes up quietly at 7 o'clock sharp. The staff check no one's escaped or died. Then breakfast is served.
So it's like continental breakfast then?
Yeah.
No bacon and eggs then?
No, not at all.
Aye, 14 years. They're no bad, because I'm no too bad. No, you know, I've learnt a few wee things. Anyway, I'm about to finish now with a wee song. Auld Lang Syne is a Robbie Burns poem, usually sung on New Year's Eve at the stroke of midnight, but in fact it's more traditionally sung on the 25th of January, Robbie Burns night, and it's about love and friendship. And Auld Lang Syne is old Scottish dialect for all times past. Should all acquaintance be forgot and never brought to mind? Should all acquaintance be forgot and Auld Lang Syne? For Auld Lang Syne, my dear, for Auld Lang Syne, we'll tak a cup for kindness yet for Auld Lang Syne. Don't all cheer at once, aye. No, you'd have noticed there's no sake of Auld Lang Syne like the English people sing, because Auld Lang Syne really means old time's sake. So you wouldn't sing for the sake of Auld Lang Syne, would you? It doesn't make any sense now. So there you go. There's a wee bit of education for you English people. All right? So get those words right for New Year. Otherwise, I might be paying you a wee visit with those tools I mentioned earlier in my training. So, happy Christmas to each and every one of you. And happy New Year for 2013. So, I'm just going to pass you over to that other one who presented the video at the beginning.
Thank you so much to our friend from Glasgow for coming on and sending his good wishes to you all. I thought to finish, I would return to my royal chair and wish you all a prosperous New Year and a Merry Christmas. Now, you may have noticed that I've got quite a lot of presents here. And unfortunately, as Philip is rather bladdered, still in hospital, he won't be getting any of these presents, so I've got them all to open myself. I've got rather a lot of presents, so as you can see, I'm rather excited. Oh, it's from Charlie. Oh, what a miser. That's rather small. That one's from Kate. Phew, here's a rather big one. Yeah. It's from dearest Andrew. Probably the same rubbish she sent me last year. Personally, I prefer the bag. I can take this horse riding with me. Before I go, I would like to draw your attention to the rather ostentatious Christmas trees that were sent to me this year. On the left, here we have one that was sent from the person who is posing as the Queen at Buckingham Palace, Elizabeth Windsor. She sent me this and told me it was real pearls, but I have put one through my teeth and found that they are false. Trafalgar Square, due to the cuts, were scaling things down, so we had a rather smaller version of the tree sent to us. And of course, I made rather a fuss about the tinsel because I wanted it to match my headscarf when I go back to my cottage. On the right, we have another example, which was sent from our dear friends across the water in Canada. Very expensive, but again, I tried it and it wasn't genuine. This other tree comes all the way from East Dagenham. I think it was made in a school there. How sweet. They sent it to me, and I rather prefer it to the others. Here's wishing you all a prosperous, happy New Year. Enjoy your turkey.